everyone, and welcome to Sunflower Memories 2020. This weekend, we would usually invite you into our hospice gardens to have a cup of tea and cake with us, to share stories and celebrate the lives of loved ones. Unfortunately, this year, it's not been possible to do so. And I think 2020 is turning out to be a year that none of us could ever have predicted. We've had to close our shops, cancel our events, but all the way through, it's been really, really important to us that we run our Sunflower Memories appeal.
Yes, every year we welcome hundreds of you into our hospice gardens in July. And we know just from talking to you how important Sunflower Memories really is. So in a year when we've all been asked to stay at home, when some of us are self-isolating on our own, finding ways to support each other and to share experiences we felt was more important than ever.
So today we're going to hear from some of our supporters, Alison, Andrew, Roger and David, who are going to talk to us about the care of the hospice that they have experienced. They're also going to be talking about why Sunflower Memories is so important to them. We have supporters and volunteers and staff reading out some beautiful poems, as well as music from various artists. And this includes our usual guitarists, Johnny and Nev.
Yes, as well as all of this, we're going to be taking you on a journey behind the scenes of Sunflower Memories, talking to the team that would usually host you here at the hospice and are missing the opportunity to welcome you today. We're also going to be talking to the incredible team who donate the seeds, the pots, the compost and spend months growing 300 sunflowers ready for the events for you each year. And finally, we're going to talk to some of the staff here at the hospice who have been working throughout the pandemic to find out what it's really been like over the last few months. So I hope you're sitting comfortably. Grab yourself a cup of tea and a slice of cake. And make sure you have your sunflower memory marker nearby. This film is our way of bringing a little bit of the magic of sunflower memories to you here in the comfort of your own home.
I first tried to use this when my wife was ill, and I got halfway around, and the feeling this gives you is really, really moving, and I had to go off. But since then, I've found that walking around it, I feel relieved, I suppose. It's all the things I'm anxious about. By the time I've finished it, I feel a lot better. Walking around it is very, very emotional. It brings back memories. And when I've finished, I must admit, I feel a lot better.
And David, can you tell me a little bit about your wife, Christine?
Yes, my wife was diagnosed with a brain tumour. And we were told that she only had 6 months to live. And I was struggling. I went and saw my GP, and he said, "Oh, you know, I've told you to go to Pilgrims." And I said, "Yeah, but you know, she's not ready for that." He said, no, they're there for any time." And so we came here, and they helped with all her tablets. And at one stage, all the tablets went wrong. She came in for a few days, and they got all the tablets right again, so she was able to come back home. And by this time I got a stair lift in, and then they said, you know, do you need help at home? When I come, you see other people who are also remembering their loved ones, and it's good to be here to see them and see the people who've helped me get through this very difficult time. And on top of that, it's always fun giving money to Pilgrims Hospice if there's something going on. And coming here and buying the sunflowers and giving donations, it makes you feel, what's the right word? It makes you feel very thankful that they're here and do all the good work that they do.
So these sunflower markers are really significant for you in terms of your relationship with Mitch.
They really are. I've had one from the year that he passed away, which is very fortunate for me to actually have this.
So Alison, tell us a little bit about Mitch and how you first met.
We first met when I had a very good friend who took me to her local pub in a beautiful village near Faversham. And Mitch managed the pub and was also the chef. And the food was incredible. He was so bright and it was a very, very, very popular pub. And all the locals absolutely loved him. I was apprehensive to start with. I don't know why, because when I eventually said yes, We had an amazing time.
So can you explain why Sunflower Memories is so poignant to you?
Sunflower Memories is so important to me because when Mitch and I got together, he arranged this amazing date. And he was working during the day and he sent me a photo on the phone that he'd taken of himself, and it was of himself behind a massive bunch of sunflowers. And that was on our first date. And from that point, he just always gave me flowers, chocolates, everything. But always when sunflowers were out, we always had sunflowers. And then on the 1st of July 2014, Mitch was diagnosed with esophageal cancer. We came here for some advice, and we were due to potentially use the facilities. However, we weren't given very long. We had 13 days.
Loved, therefore I am, and in being loved I am treasured. When I peeled away my layers, and all that was left was my essence, the bareness of me, I was still loved.
I was loved, therefore I am, and in being loved I was able to grow.
In my mistakes held, in my successes celebrated, I was always loved.
I was loved, therefore I am, and in being loved I learnt to love.
In the sun-filled day, in the ecstasy of the night, I was loved and loved others. To be loved is all you need. I was loved, and so I will always be.
I just think sitting in this beautiful garden, reminiscing with other families really about how they were well looked after in the hospice, because that is a lot of feedback that I get from the hospice, from patients. And in this beautiful setting, and just to look at people's sunflowers that they've dedicated in memory of their loved one, it's just a special occasion. And I came here and I have never ever looked back since. I find it so humbling to be part of this wonderful charity. Everybody makes you feel welcome. And I'm so glad that I answered yes to this calling.
If you don't already have a dedicated sunflower and you would like one, please go onto Sunflower Memories page on our website.
So those of you that have been to Sunflower Memories in the past will know that one of the biggest features of the event is the hundreds of sunflower plants that we have available for you to buy on the day. 300 to be exact, we plant 100 sunflowers for each hospice site. Now, what many of you may not realise is that everything from the pots, the seeds, the compost, it's all generously donated.
We were only too happy to donate the seeds and I believe some compost at times.
Jackie, can you explain your involvement with the hospice?
I've had family and friends that have unfortunately passed away from there. But my main thing is because it's so close, it's part of Thanet, it's nice to actually be able to contribute and help to raise money for all the good work they do, because it's amazing. The support they give is fantastic, and actually you never know when you're going to need them yourself or your family.
So last year in my previous job I worked at a Fifth Trust, which is a day centre for adults with learning disabilities, and we grew the sunflowers there on our nursery, which we grew for yourselves. I think there was about 150 sunflowers we grew. Made nice plants, sort of 12 inches, 14 inch plants, and then brought them to you guys over at the Pilgrims Hospice when they're all in flower, ready for you to sell.
So these are really beautiful sunflowers we have here. They're just like the ones that we have at Sunflower Memories events. Can you tell us how you go about growing them and making them so beautiful for the day?
They come to us, tiny little seeds, and then we put them into some potting compost, germinate them, and then once they've germinated they're about an inch tall, and then we pot them up into bigger pots. Yep. And then we put them in sort of a 9 centimetre pot. And then after that, within about 2 to 3 weeks, we'll put them into a bigger pot, and the pot will be in this sort of size, yep. A sort of 1.5, 2 litre per size pot. And then we'll leave them to grow, water them every couple of days, somewhere nice and warm and sunny.
and then within sort of 8 to 9 weeks they'll be ready.
So some interesting facts about the sunflower. As you can see, that if I hold the leaves back here a little bit, you can see lots of different buds on the sunflower. There's probably about 8 different buds on there. So again, as soon as one of the buds finishes, you can cut that bud off and then a new one will appear. So make sure you feed them as well, because if you feed plants, they grow well, they green up nicely, and they're happy, a bit like us, they need to be fed. And then make sure that you water them on a regular basis. You know, on a hot day like today, they need watering. On a cool day, when it's not so hot, you know, they don't need so much water. But just make sure that, you know, they do get fed. It's a good good tip. So, if you'd like to take these with you.
Oh, thank you very much. That's
all right,
really
you're
kind.
Welcome.
Thank you.
I started in 2015 growing the sunflowers for the Memories Day and also helping to put the plaques in the ground. Once we get the seeds and the compost, usually about mid-May, I take everything home with me, and in my greenhouse I sow the seeds into individual little pots, and once they start to grow I then pot them on into bigger and bigger pots, basically, until they end up in a pot about a 2 or 3 litre size when they're ready for sunflower memories and hopefully for people to buy them.
So Jen, you actually have another very, very important job in sunflower memories. Do you want to let us know what that is?
Yes, once I've grown all the sunflowers and they're in their pots ready for the day before, a small team of us, about 4 or 5 of us, come up the day before and we have a whole bunch of the plaques. And it's our job is to put them in the ground all the way round this area. We walk round planting them, and what happens is a couple of them lay them out. We lay them out.
This is my mum, and we both work in the hospice. Mum's been working longer than I have, but I'm here as well, just to help and to give benefit to many, if possible. And I just love the place.
So I started off as a volunteer on the desk. Then I worked in the office for a while, helping with the finance and banking checks and Tree of Love and that sort of thing. Then I had a bit of a break, then came back working on all the different functions that go on during the year. And it does give a lot of comfort to people. I'm quite surprised, actually.
We know the main reason, but obviously, the other reason is comfort for people.
Just under 8 years ago, my husband died. So, and although he didn't stay here, we did use the hospice at home, which was, well, I can't begin to say how wonderful they were. And it helped me a lot. And knowing somebody was at the end of the phone is always a good thing.
If you do have a sunflower, please hold it close while we go over to Bryony Kapoor, who's reading I Am There from the beautiful atmospheric All Saints Church in New Romney.
Look for me when the tide is high and the gulls are wheeling overhead. When the autumn wind sweeps the cloudy sky and one by one the leaves are shed. I am there where the river flows and salmon leap to a silver moon. Where the insects hum and the tall grass grows and sunlight warms the afternoon. I am there in the busy street. I take your hand in the city square, in the marketplace where the people meet. In your quiet room, I am there. I am the love you cannot see, and all I ask is, look for me.
Author Bodie Smith writes, look at its shape, with vibrant yellows and oranges, a sunflower can brighten your day. So if you only do one thing all day, let it be to smile, so you can brighten the day of others around you, just like the sunflower. Pilgrims Therapy Centre Wellbeing Programme is a vital part of the care and support we provide our patients and their families. But this would not be possible without your generosity and your continued support of events such as Sunflowers. So thank you so much.
I serve the teas and coffees with my friend Annie. We also serve cakes, biscuits and that to the lovely people that come along. And this is our gopher, Steve.
Thank you. Well, I've been called lots of things in my time, but I'm happy to take that, and because that's my role. You know, I've been behind the scenes person assisting Annie and Brenda, so, you know, making sure that I'm rushing up the stairs, getting the milk when it's getting low, making sure there's enough tea in the pot, and generally be in charge of supplies.
I think it brings people together. They've all gone through the same thing. And it's just so nice, and as you say, when the weather's lovely, it really is a lovely day. Though last year it wasn't so good, and there was a lot of stuff going inside, but they seem to enjoy it, the children enjoy it when they come, and it's a lovely day.
A really important event, and I've volunteered to do this for the last few years, and I really love it, and it's just so nice. In my little gopher's role of going around collecting cups and things, it just gives you an opportunity to talk to people about why they've come to the event and what it means for them, and whether that's someone just sitting on their own that's just reflecting about losing a loved one who just likes a little chat and tells you their story, to groups that are also having lots of laughter and have all their stories to tell about. It's just quite magical, and I love it, and it's just an honour and a pleasure really to be here and help you know, take part in the event. And I think the sunflower itself is such a lovely emblem, and you know, it means such a lot, and seeing them in the nice weather and them all blossoming, I just think it adds such a big thing to the event.
A lot of clearing up to do.
Lots and lots of clearing up to do. Yeah, we have. It's quite colourful, but it's not tidy, is it?
No, that's what it looks. A bit unkempt. Yeah. Bit like our hair, actually.
Yes.
So we gradually got involved by getting the seed sent to us from free, for obviously given to the charity. We had to then pot those in tiny little pots, take lots of tender, loving care of them, mostly here, water them regularly, go and make sure that they were all spread out evenly on various places, and then gradually pot them on into bigger pots, took some home to look after, some we left here, and then gradually brought them on to be able to reach perfection time, obviously with a lot of praying and dancing around for sunshine and a right amount of water to sell.
And my involvement in the hospice started when my husband was in the Canterbury Hospice 20 odd years ago. And when he died, I was still working. But as soon as I retired, I decided it was time to do some support for the hospice.
Yeah, I'm just underneath, not a lot. But we can get some of this rubbish out.
Well, I've just found some aquilegas that have died off, and the dead heads needs to come off, otherwise they will seed everywhere.
Sadly, we are in the middle of a global pandemic. It's been tough, it's been challenging, it's been very sad. The main part of our job as catering is that we like to go to our patients every single day, sometimes three or four times a day. So that interaction and that one-to-one time with that patient has left a bit of a void in my working day that I actually quite miss. But we would so love for you to be here, but unfortunately you can't. So please enjoy the video, the recipes, everything else that's been done virtually.
So every year at Sunflower Memories, you come to the event and you write your messages to your loved ones on these cards, and we put them all on the memory wall along with your photographs and your messages. But this year, because we can't invite you to the hospice, we've created an online memory wall where you can go online and you can post your messages and your photographs. And lots of people have done this already, but if you haven't had a chance yet, it's not too late. Just go on to the Sunflower Memory page of our website. For you.
think 3 or 4 years I've been helping out with Sunflower Memories. In the main, I've helped with parking. It's a very popular event, and parking is quite difficult in this area. So we use a lot of the garden as the car park, and a couple of us manage to direct the traffic and get everybody lined up and make sure we get everybody in and comfortable and safe.
So Richard, how do you feel that Pilgrims Hospices helps others?
I think it's a very special event in the sense that it gives people an opportunity to reflect on their experience with the hospice, the families and friends of people who've sadly passed away. They'll have been under some stress during that period of time.
My mother-in-law died here 20 years ago, actually in the Ashford one, and it was marvellous then. But we actually had a friend who died here about 12 years ago, and even in those times, that number of years, it improved again. And they were marvellous, even though we were friends, they never turned us away and let us carry on like we were just in somebody's house. I love it, actually. I think it's really nice to get to talk to people and, you know, just people still want to talk, however many years it is. It's something that they still want to do, you know, and it's not for everybody, but it is for a lot of people, really important to come and have their sunflower and put it in the hospice garden. Like never
before. So since the sunflower appeal has started, it's raised £222,000, which is enough to fund a palliative specialist nurse for up to 5 years. So we have a team of palliative specialist nurses. They go out into the community and provide support to up to 1,000 patients at one time. Without a shadow of a doubt, this pandemic has affected every single one of us, hasn't it, on a personal level. Personally, for me, it's been really hard. My husband is also a nurse. He works for Pilgrims too. So we've had to come to work every day. We've got 2 children who have had to kind of homeschool each other. So it's been really hard trying to make sure they're okay whilst having to do whatever we need to do at work. And, you know, some of the decisions that we've had to make and at work and at home have been just really emotionally challenging and draining sometimes. So it's been physically hard as well as emotionally hard for us all, I think.
I'm one of the specialty doctors here. I've been here since mid-Feb 2013, so nearly 7.5 years, I think. And I have worked across the 3 sites in that time. I have worked in the hospitals in that time and done lots of home visits. And aside from doing this, which you can see I'm not fantastic with, I've done most things here, I would say.
So Simon, for you, what's important about Sunflower Memories and fundraising events like this at the hospice?
If it weren't for charitable people, and very charitable people in some cases, passing on generous donations, most of us wouldn't have a job here. Most of us wouldn't be able to do the things that I think add some value to the last stages of somebody's life, and something that their loved ones tend to remember years on. And you do bump into these people sometimes, whether it be back at the hospice or sometimes if you're going shopping nearby, which I sometimes do. So it is very well valued. Remember me when the flowers bloom in the early spring. Remember me on sunny days in the fun that summer brings. Remember me in the fall as you walk through fields of gold. And in the wintertime, remember me in the stories that are told. But most of all, remember each day, right from the start, I will be forever near, for I live within your heart. And the songbirds keep singing like they
know the score. And I love you, I love you, I love you.
It's all part of Remembering Jan, and it sort of links into my experience at the hospice. It's a good time to get together. Of course, I think about it every day, but it's good to have these sunflower memories.
Pete came in on a Thursday morning at the end of June 20,
18. And when he came in, he was all ready, sedated and calm and quiet. And you just sit with them and you feel comforted somehow.
I think
if he'd been at home, there wouldn't have been the calm, the comfort.
It sort of happened, didn't it?
Well, you... you...
Careful what you're
saying.
..saw
me when I was taking my very old dog out.
Yes. And then it just developed, and then...
friendship, wasn't
we came to the conclusion almost at the same time that we wanted to be partners.
Zoe and I were together since we were about 14. Brilliant times, remembered all the time, and got married when we were about 20. And then on our first wedding anniversary, unfortunately, we found out that she had a rare type of brain and bone cancer, about the size of your fist at the base of her spine. Spent a lot of time up in London with all the family, trying to get bits removed by specialists, and then sort of about a year and a half into everything, she then got sent to the hospice for pain management and palliative care in that respect, not for anything else that we were expecting at the time. And Zoe didn't want to come in the first place, because the initial thoughts that we have of hospice is you come here to die, unfortunately. It's a horrible thing to say. And trying to get that out of our heads was quite difficult, but as soon as we came through the doors, we realised that wasn't the case at all. And it was just being welcomed by people who knew how to manage pain and really take care of Zoe when she really needed it was just brilliant and really welcoming at the time. I couldn't praise the hospice enough, I really couldn't, and I couldn't do enough for the hospice. And everything we do as a family, it sort of is all geared towards trying to raise money for the hospice as one of our main charities for whenever we do anything, just to do that. And that kind of shows as a wider family that we're in it for the long haul, or something along those lines. And I love you, I love you, I love you like never before.
So in the lead up today, we asked you, our supporters, to send us your photos and your videos of who you're remembering for Sunflower Memories.
This is in memory of John Wunstall. John passed away on the 2nd of March this year. He's terribly missed by so many people. His four boys, his four grandsons, his family, and certainly myself and Harry.
Yeah.
What do you miss most?
Well, everyone got on well with him. Every time we go out, he'd chat to everyone. We usually had film nights every Friday. Then we don't really have that anymore, do we?
It's not quite the same, is it?
Yeah, everyone got on well with him.
But we've done the memory sunflower, and that's going to be in our garden. We spent a lot of time, and life's not quite the same.
For you.
This is our son Joshua. He passed away aged 18 at the Pilgrims Hospice in Canterbury. We've put Joshua's sunflower with his cactus that he bought when he was a child. Always remember the Pilgrims Hospice looking after Joshua. And also all the support they gave family and friends at the time of his illness. The sunflower reminds us of his beautiful smile.
We've come to an end. I just want to say a huge thank you to all of you for joining us today. As the person who's responsible for organising these events each year, it's been a real pleasure to introduce you to the really hard-working team that go into making this happen. So if you haven't yet had a chance to dedicate your sunflower memory marker, it's not too late. You can do that by going onto the Sunflower Memories page of the Pilgrims Hospices website.
Yes, thank you so much for joining us. Although we've not been able to invite you into the gardens this year, we hope that by listening to the stories in this film and remembering our loved ones, that it's brought you a sense of comfort. I'd like to thank you for your support, because we really couldn't do what we do without you. Thank you.
Thank you. Let's keep